Good morning, Arizona students. Welcome to the HYFN-TV Morning News Show. I'm Tiffany.
I'm Diego.
And I'm Jay Will. It's Friday!
Rocking around the Christmas tree at the Christmas party hop. Mistletoe hung where you can see everything.
It is Friday, and we are just going to dive right back into talking about those hypersonic activities. Not too long ago, we reported to you on the development of hypersonic glide vehicles and hypersonic rockets being developed by China. There is a new development in the story, with China now far surpassing the United States and Russia by developing a 148-foot long plane, which would be the world's first supersonic airliner. This plane would be about a third of the size of a Boeing 737, and making it different from other planes, the tips of the wings are pointed up. What's crazy is that they actually already have a prototype built by a Chinese research team, and it was unveiled by Chinese space scientists. Even crazier, it was inspired by the Boeing Manta X-47C. Okay, so why am I saying that that's even crazier? Here's why. Because the Boeing Manta was a NASA project in the 2000s. That's right, you heard me correctly, we were already developing a hypersonic plane, and while technically Ming Han Tang, who was the head engineer of NASA's hypersonic program in the late 1990s, designed the two-stage vehicle, or the TSV-X plane. This plane was powered by two separate engines on the sides, whereas most hypersonic aircraft have the engine just in the belly. Ming's testing was canceled by the U.S. government in the early 2000s due to technical challenges and costs. And yep, you guessed it, that's exactly when China's hypersonic weapons program started. Professor Tan Hujin from Nanjing University of Aeronautics and Astronautics, who was part of building the prototype, stated, "The U.S. government had largely ignored Ming's idea, but in China, the design was gaining traction because understanding its work mechanism can provide important guidance to hypersonic plane and engine development. Too bad for the U.S., I guess. Their ultimate goal is to have a jet that can transport at least 10 passengers anywhere in the world within just 1 hour by 2035. I mean, could you imagine that? Well, we will definitely be keeping track of the story and bringing you updates as we carry on our coverage of the hypersonic vehicles. Now let's go to Jay Will for a recap of that Suns game last night.
Thanks, Tiff. The Phoenix Suns took care of business last night with a decisive win over a struggling Washington Wizards team. The Suns now have won 13 straight games at home and are 23-5 on the season, tied for the best record in the NBA and their best start to a season in 16 years. They gave the Wizards no life by playing great defense with a balanced offense. Eight players scored in double figures as JaVale McGee was the star of the bench as he dropped 17 points last night. Also, all 11 players who saw the court last night for the Suns, they scored at least a bucket. The Suns held the lead the entire game simply because the Wizards just weren't playing good enough. And the Suns took advantage of what was given and went on to cruise to 118-98 win. The Suns now have 2 days off. Their next game is Sunday night against the Charlotte Hornets at the Suns Arena.